WinCC version 8 step-by-step, creating a connection to an external REST service. Hey guys, in this video, we're going to use the REST connector editor to create a connection to WeatherStack, which will give us information about the local weather. We'll configure this, and we're going to create a screen. And in runtime, we'll be able to trigger this connection and get the JSON containing information about the local weather. And then we'll write a VB script to pull some of that information into tags that we can use in our process. So if this sounds interesting, let's get started. So before we begin in WinCC, we need to find a REST service that we're going to use. I wanted to do something useful, which is pulling in weather information into our SCADA. I have some customers that use this in wastewater and things like that. So there's a lot of services out there. I chose WeatherStack. It's pretty easy to use. It's free. And what you're going to do is, if you go to WeatherStack, that's fine, or you can use another one, but you need to sign up and get an API key. And an API key just allows you to use the service. So for every call you make, you have to send that API key in. And most services give you like $1,000 or so per month free. So plenty to use for testing without having to pay. And of course, if you want to use this, you can get a subscription and pay. And then you can go to the documentation. And so here is a URL. It has my access key in there. So of course, I've blurred it out. But we can see exactly how this works. We'll hit run API. And it is going to show you the JSON that comes back, and you just pull out the bits that you want and use them in your SCADA application. So once you've identified your REST server and you've gotten your API key, it's time to go to WinCC and configure a connection to this service. So we're going to start in WinCC Explorer, and we're going to make sure that we're not in runtime, and we're just going to open up the REST connector. We have to take a look at our URL. This is going to be the server, and then this part is going to be your endpoint, and together they should make a fully qualified URL. And so I'm just going to highlight this part, and on my server, I'll right click and do new server, and I am using Control V just to paste that in. So there's my URL server. And then we're going to need an endpoint, and that is going to be the last part of this. And of course, you're going to need your API key, and you're going to replace this, including the brackets there. So this is going to be our endpoint. And of course, you would put your city or town there. So we'll right-click, create a new endpoint. We will paste that in there. And I am going to replace this portion with my API key. Now, we want to change our mode to get because we are getting this information, and we're going to create some trigger tags. And so we'll pull out and look at this information, and we're going to need a trigger tag. And we're also going to need a tag for our status and something to receive our answer. So our trigger tag is going to be binary. Our status is going to be an integer, and our answer is going to be a string tag. So we'll go over to tag management, and we're going to create a group, and I'm just going to call this weather, and I will create a weather trigger, and that's going to be a binary tag. I'll create weather status, which just gives us a numerical status of our request, and we can tell whether it is good or bad there. So I'll just do unsigned 16-bit. And we need a weather answer, which this is where our JSON comes into. So we'll do Unicode character set here. And those are our tags. Now, going back to our REST connector, we are going to set our trigger to our weather trigger. And just anytime it changes, it is going to trigger this call. And then I'm going to go back and select my endpoint. And my answer tag will be my text weather answer tag, and my status will be my status tag. And we can use these to request and get information. And so at this point, we need to do file save. Now, this is a little different because some of the other editors, most of the other editors, you don't have to save. And also, I'll note that if you're in runtime, it kind of throws up a warning about resetting and retriggering and things like that. So when you're setting this up for the first time, it's a good idea to not be in runtime. So we have this set up. I'm going to make sure it's saved, and then we'll just exit this. Back in WinCC Explorer, or you'll want to go to your computer properties, which we'll look at the new properties in Configuration Studio. And under Bob's Dev, you want to make sure that your REST service is checked. And then for your local settings, I am using my Web UX certificate as a certificate for this, which the weather service I'm using doesn't support HTTPS unless you have a paid subscription, so I don't know that it matters. And then we can close this, and we need to create a screen, so I'm going to open Graphics Designer, and we'll create a new screen. I'm just going to save it as weather, and maybe just kind of size this. So we're going to need to be able to trigger our tag. So I'm going to pull up the tag browser here. I'll go into my weather. Here's my trigger. I'll pull this out. And my status, I'll go ahead and pull this out. And then for my weather answer, what I'm going to do, because it's going to come in as a lot of text, I'm just going to do this multi-row text. And for object properties, I'll just go to font and just hook up that tag directly to this multi-line text. And I'm going to make it easy to see, so I'll background it as white and give it black font. And I'll just go ahead and throw a couple of labels on here. And I'll just kind of clean everything up. Set these guys up for alignment. And just hit save. So this is my trigger tag, and so I should be able to just change this. And if everything goes okay, we'll get a status 200 in here, and our response will pop in here. So we can just hit save and go to runtime. And I will hit my trigger, and boom, there we go. We've got our JSON coming in, and this is Alpharetta. You can see we've got the local time, the temperature, the weather code. They even give you some links to different images based on the type of weather. So the next steps would be to parse this JSON and put it onto a screen or otherwise use it in your SCADA environment. So let's do a little VB scripting to grab this information out and throw it into some internal tags so that we could easily use it in our application. Let's take a look at the JSON first. The information we want is right here, starting with current. And so what we'll do is we'll get the index of this first value, observation time, and we'll grab the rest of the string. And then it's all broken up by these commas, so we could split that out into an array, which would just give us an array of key value pairs, and then we could break these up and throw them into tags. So I'll create some tags for some of these values, observation time, temperature, things like that, and we'll write the script. So we'll go back to Graphics Designer, and I've added a button with some Visual Basic scripting on it, and I am going to grab this application window, and that you can use this as kind of a debug console. And I'll just say I want a global script diagnostics. So when you put this object on, if you do a print statement in either C or VBS, it will print out onto that. So it's pretty handy when you're writing scripts and debugging. And looking at this code, I am grabbing the JSON from our weather answer, and I am finding the index of our JSON string where our current information begins, so observation time. And then I'm doing a mid function to just get that last part of that string. So that's just gonna get us this string here. And then we're gonna do a split function, which splits a string out into arrays, and we're gonna split it by commas. And what we're gonna end up with is an array with all our key value pairs. And I'm using HMI runtime trace with a number to print out this information to see if it's what we want. And that's gonna be printed here. So I'm just going to hit save and go to runtime and process the JSON. And so you can see here, I've got my key and my value for all of this. Now I can just grab this information by doing a little bit more string manipulation and put it into some tags. So going back to tag management, I went ahead and created some tags. I just named them the same as some of the keys that I wanted to get out of the current weather conditions array. And so I created observation time, which is text, temperature, which is a float, wind speed, which is unsigned 16, and also the wind direction. And I'm just going to grab these. These are the tags that we want to write. And we'll go back to our script. I'm just going to paste in these names here real quick. so I don't forget them. Now, let's take a quick look at the printout from this again to get an idea of how we're going to populate the tags. So we'll go back into runtime. I need to get element 0, 1, 5, and 7. 0, 1, 5, and 7. So going back to Graphics Designer, I went ahead and created labels and I/O fields for the tags. I didn't want to bore you with watching me set all that stuff up, but we've got observation time, temperature, wind direction, and wind speed. And then I've also updated the script here. Basically, these are the elements that we need. And the way that this script works is I create some variables to just grab the information. And if we're going to split the array out, then I'm going to need a temporary to split that out and then just take the elements that we need. First, we just use temp and we get element 0, which is observation time. But if you recall, the observation time, if you split it by a colon, well, there's also a colon in the time, so we have to treat that a little differently. So basically, we split that, and then we just take elements 1 and 2. Remember, arrays start with 0, so 0 is going to be the name of the key, and then the element 1 and 2 put together will be the value of our observation time. And then I'm doing a replace statement to replace double quotes with an empty string here, so char34, and then I'm just kind of tracing that out to see it, and then I'm writing that value to the tag. For the other elements, we just have to take the second array element, which is element number 1. So I split out vArray 1, which is our temperature, write it to the tag, get element 5 of our array, split that out, write that to wind speed, do the same thing here. So we can just save this page and go to runtime. And first we have to trigger the call. We do get our JSON, and then when we run our script, it does fill in our observation time, temperature, wind direction, and wind speed and put it into our tags. So I'll leave the rest up to you. Hopefully this was helpful. If it was, I would really appreciate it if you would like and subscribe. Also share my channel with your colleagues that could benefit from these videos, and drop me a comment. Let me know what you think or some suggestions on videos in the future. Thanks for watching.